Sergeant Slaughter, you've been in seclusion now for well over a month. In my travels around the country, there isn't a person who doesn't agree that you got what you deserved at SummerSlam. As a matter of fact, I think you got exactly what you deserved during that match made in hell.
You're right. I got exactly what I deserved at that match made in hell at SummerSlam. When I reflect back, when I wanted to become the World Wrestling Federation champion, I didn't care who I associated with. The scum of the earth, the slime, the sleaze. It didn't matter who I chummed with. I wanted to become the World Wrestling Federation champion at all costs. I didn't care about my family anymore. I didn't care about my friends anymore. I didn't care about my country. I turned my back on my country. I wanted to become the World Wrestling Federation champion. I was blind by ambition.
Oh, I have a special message from President Saddam Hussein. He will never, ever leave Kuwait.
I didn't care what or who or why I had to do what I did. I stepped on everyone. But you don't know what it's like to be in hell, because I do.
When I, Sergeant Slaughter, will wear the boots, the gift from President Saddam Hussein, and I will reach out and take what I want.
I lost the World Wrestling Federation Championship. I lost a title, a symbol, but more importantly, I lost self-respect. I lost self-esteem. I lost my family. I lost my friends. But most important is I lost my country. I don't blame my friends for never wanting to speak to me again. I've lost them. There's nothing I can do about that. I don't expect my family to ever forgive me for what I did. I have to live with that. I don't expect anybody to look at Sergeant Slaughter and say, "Oh, we're sorry, Sergeant Slaughter. I deserve exactly what I got." But there's one thing above all those things I just spoke of that I want. And I want it real, real bad. And that is, I want my country back. Why? I don't care if I ever get into a wrestling ring again. That's why I don't care if I ever wrestle again. I don't care about titles anymore. The reason I'm here today is to ask for their forgiveness, to beg for their forgiveness, for if it's the last breath of air out of this body, I want my country back.
Sergeant Slaughter, to be standing at the base of the Lincoln Memorial. As you know, Abraham Lincoln was a forgiving man. It was a proud day on August 2nd. When President Saddam Hussein conquered Kuwait. But just as Abraham Lincoln took a nation divided and made it whole again, I too, Sergeant Slaughter, need to be made whole again. But in order to do that, I need my brothers. I need my country. And it was also a proud day when President Saddam Hussein presented to me this great gift, my country back. Uncommon valor was a common virtue of men like these. They said it in the Atlantic. They said it in the Pacific. They said it in Asia. And they're still saying it today. And as I stand in the shadow of this great monument of bravery and freedom,
wonder how on earth I could have done what I've done. How could I have done it? I only wish that one day I will be able to stand with uncommon valor again. I only wish I could be up there right now helping plant Old Glory. I only wish that I had a country. That's why, in honor and memory of all the great Americans who fought and died for this great country, I say to you, I want my country back.